Good day, everyone. Welcome to our first lesson on gender and society. What does it mean to be a male or a female? To be feminine or masculine? Or to be a man or woman? The human mind and body are so complex that to answer these questions, we have to trace our journey from the moment we were born and go back to the journey we humans have across the lifespan. First thing you need to understand is the complexities of defining and differentiating sex, gender, and sexuality. Having a clear grasp of these concepts is crucial since we will be using these terms over and over again in the succeeding discussions. Moreover, as we start our discussion of gender and sexuality as social realities, we also want to understand how a person's gender is expressed from birth to adulthood. Our ultimate goal is to foster understanding of the diversity of how humans experience and express their sexuality. Let's start with the word sex. Sex is a biological dimension of your gender and sexuality. It is also referred to as biological sex or physical sex. The term generally pertains to your identity depending on your sexual anatomy and physiology, which means parts of your body that are relevant to reproduction and the functions of these parts. Sex is typically determined by examining your genitals. These are external organs that are associated with reproduction, the process or the ability to create offspring. Among humans, sex is often assigned at birth. If at birth, the child is observed to have a penis and testicles, then the child is categorized as male. If on the other hand, the child is observed to have a vagina, then the child is categorized as female. However, there are cases when the baby's genitals appear to be a conglomerate of male and female organs, such that it may be difficult to classify the baby's sex without further examination. In the past, this condition is referred to as hermaphroditism. From Hermes, a male Greek god, and Aphrodite, a female Greek goddess. In modern times, the term intersexuality is used to refer to this phenomenon. Since it may be difficult to distinguish biological sex by merely examining the genitals, there are other biological markers used. For instance, your chromosomes. Chromosomes are protein structures which contain your genetic materials and are also used to determine sex. There are specific chromosomes referred to as sex chromosomes, which marks a person's biological sex. An individual with set of XY sex chromosomes is said to be a male, while an individual with a set of XX sex chromosomes is said to be a female. The level of some hormones are chemicals in our body that are responsible for sustaining bodily processes, are also used as markers. For example, human males tend to have higher levels of testosterone, which is associated to sex drive and aggressions. On the other hand, human females tend to have higher levels of estrogen and progesterone, which are associated to lactation, menstruation, and other female reproductive functions. However, Humans are meaning-making organisms. Our ability for higher-order thinking and our tendency to create social norms allow us to attach social and cultural meanings to things, including our sex. For example, males are typically expected to be masculine and females are expected to be feminine. Once parents are aware of their child's sex, male or female, during birth or through prenatal procedures such as ultrasound, they automatically attach social and cultural meanings to their child's sex, and in doing so, they already set an expectation in terms of how their child should behave and how they should treat their children. This social dimension of one's sexuality is referred to as gender. There are many ways through which gender is manifested. As soon as a new baby arrives in the family, adults surrounding the baby manifest their social interpretation of the baby's sex by the colors assigned to the baby. For example, it is common for families to buy blue apparels and toys when the baby is male, as the color blue is associated with boyhood. Conversely, female babies are often assigned the color pink, such that families would buy clothes and toys that are color pink because the color is associated with girlhood. Remarkably, the moment a baby is born, the name, toys, and apparels are picked by parents and relatives based on their interpretation of the baby's sex. Throughout childhood and adolescence, this assignment becomes more complex as the expectations go beyond the kind of clothes worn, but also in terms of how the person must or must not behave. There are a set of behaviors that all female individuals must follow, and so with the male individuals, and all are expected to stick to these behaviors that are aligned to their biological sex. This phenomenon of determining the normality of a behavior based on whether it conforms or not to the expectations relative to one's biological sex is referred to as heteronormativity. In the Filipino culture, girls are expected to have certain characteristics of being gentle, caring, and loving, while boys are encouraged to be strong, rough, and assertive. These expectations also extend to how men and women are expected to behave, the college course they take, and the jobs they apply to. However, there are people who do not follow culturally accepted standards of masculinity and femininity, like girls not wanting to wear dresses and boys not wanting to play rough sports. This is a natural variation of the human gender expression. Social and cultural practices change through time. Just 60 years ago, women could not wear pants without social disapproval. And now, wearing pants is already an accepted fashion trend among people of different genders. How we express our gender is largely based on our social and cultural setting. Most are comfortable with their sex and gender. Men who are masculine and women who are feminine. Each culture also has different standards on how a man and a woman and how they should present themselves according to their sex and gender. One important aspect of our gender is our sense of who we are. Do we see and experience ourselves as a man, a woman, or neither? This refers to our gender identity. Typically, males are comfortable identifying as men and females are comfortable identifying as a woman. However, there are cases wherein a person's biological sex does not align with their gender identity. People with this experience are referred to as transgenders, such as male who does not feel comfortable identifying as a man, they are called transgender woman, or a female who is not comfortable identifying as a woman, or transgender man. Transgender people may undergo gender reassignment surgery to align their physical characteristics to their gender identity. However, due to many factors such as belief systems, culture, and economics, some do not opt for surgery. Here are some famous Filipinos who undergo gender reassignment. The husband of Joey Mead King and Asia's Next Top Model host is Ian King, now became Angelina Mead King. The singer Charisse Pimpenko now became Jake Cyrus. And the 80s heartthrob Rostom Padilla now became Bibi Gandang Hari. Another aspect of our gender pertains to our emotional and sexual attraction to a person. This aspect refers to our sexual orientation. According to Psychological Association of the Philippines, typically at ages 6 to 8, we experience or develop attraction to other people. By adolescence, we already know who we are attracted to and would experiment dating and relationships. Everyone's sexuality is different and deeply personal. Our capacity for emotional and sexual attraction is diverse and complex. But here are few common terms or labels for us to use. People who are attracted to the opposite sex are called heterosexuals or straight. People who are attracted to people of the same sex are called homosexuals, gay or lesbian. Bisexual or bi are people who are attracted to both sexes, male or female. And LGBT refers to lesbian, gay, bisexual, and transgender community. Identifying as a heterosexual, lesbian, bi, gay, or transgender is deeply personal process, so it may be more difficult for others to come out or for them to become comfortable enough to their sexuality that they feel safe to share it with other people. For others, it comes early in adolescence, while for some, it may take some time to understand and discover themselves. According to Psychological Association of the Philippines, we can only truly tell that a person is gay, lesbian, or bisexual if the person shares with us his or her experiences or feelings of attraction towards others. That is why it is important for everyone to feel safe as they share their sexuality, since it is a personal and sensitive topic. We can do that in an environment wherein we do not feel judged or discriminated upon. People who experience prejudice and discrimination suffer negative psychological effects. So, we must work towards an inclusive environment where everyone feels safe. That's it for our first lesson. I hope you learned something. Again, no one can tell you what your gender identity is. It is you who decide what it is. Respect yourself and respect people's decision and choices. Thank you for listening. Have a great day. Bye!